Under the House leadership's design, the bill would have eliminated the state's sales tax on groceries while also getting rid of the yearly grocery tax credit we get on our taxes. It would have also raised the gas tax by 7 cents to help pay for roads, and it would have lowered the tax rates on top earners in the state. It was set to bring in about $56 million a year for transportation projects. But the bill had also been criticized for raising income taxes for some in the middle class.
That's made up stuff by the Democrats. They always do that.
The House Majority Leader says the math works out for most Idahoans.
There is a group in the middle. There's a small group that does have a small increase on the income tax, but they get more than that back by taking the sales tax off of food. So there's an impact on a small group, but it's not a very big impact.
Senators disagreed, with the entire chamber voting against the bill. They also say there were parts of it that were too complex to pass.
The general Senate disposition was to move forward in a way that maybe there's more broad support for and set these issues aside, each one individually.
Senator Cliff Bayer says the timing is also off. As lawmakers near the end of this year's legislative session, they need to take a simpler approach to each issue rather than rush through such a broad and intricate bill.
We'll now shift our focus to other transportation funding alternatives.
Senate Majority Leader Bart Davis says senators are most focused on figuring out a plan to raise transportation revenue this session. He says the Transportation Committee is working to write up some alternatives and hopes to have proposals for the Senate to consider again in a couple of days. Jacqueline Powell, KBOI News, Boise.